If someone told me I'll be testifying in front of a church 3 months ago, I would laugh at them. It's crazy how drastically God can change your life around. So like 2 weeks ago, someone was saying a testimony, and they started off with, like, where did it all go wrong? Where did you stray from God? And I believe I started straying from God, like, end of middle school, beginning of high school. I just got surrounded by the wrong group of friends. I didn't want to do what they were doing, but, like, I was always a little bit young, like, smaller than everyone, looked a little bit younger, so I just tried fitting in. So they kind of just persuaded me into the things they were doing. And, like, slowly but slowly, it just became a habit. I kind of got addicted to it, too, what they were doing. And that just leaded my life in totally the wrong direction. And time went by, and I, like, forgot how to have fun. Like, I would just work, and right after work, the only way I would have fun was through, through worldly stuff. And it didn't end well. God, like, taught me he allowed a lot of bad things to happen to me so I can learn my lesson. He allowed me to get in an accident, I believe, and then he allowed me to get arrested. And, like, slowly but slowly, I realized that God was trying to, take me away from that life and to teach me a lesson. And where was it going? And then as time went by, my dad would tell me, don't go into this. It's not worth it. And I was thinking, how can all of the people, they're like, oh, I went through it. It's not worth it. And I was like, how can they go through all of this, have fun, do the things that, all the worldly things, and then change and then become good? I was like, I just want to do all the bad things. And then later, I just want to when I get married, get close to God. But then I didn't realize all the bad consequences, all the effects it had, how it ruined your mind. It would just ruin your financial statement, accounts. And it was just all bad. So then, a month before this thing started, my friend came up to me, and he told me about this Bible college. And he already went to this Bible college 3 times, and he didn't get out of the things he was doing, so I didn't have any faith in it. And I was like, I didn't think much about it. I was like, I didn't want to go. If you can't get out of it, what makes you think I can get out of it? So I totally just shrugged it off. And then later on, the way I I came to Bible school was my dad was telling me to go get material from my friend, and I told him he doesn't work at that job no more because he went to Bible school. And I was just, as a joke, I told him, oh, maybe I should go. He's like, oh, yeah, you should really go. It can, change your life around. And I was like, if you pay for it, I'll go. And see, I ended up going I came with the wrong intentions. I totally came here just to make friends, maybe get a nice tan in California, just to take a 3-month break off work. But coming here, God really changed my life around. He taught me how to pray. He taught me, I got the Holy Spirit here. He taught me about, the spiritual world, a lot of new things. And, he just made something click in my heart. And to just wanted to strive to get to know him and to go back home and to save all my friends because they're still doing all those things. And I don't know about you guys, but I really want to go back. When I'm in heaven, I want everyone else to be around with me. And I just wanted to read a passage from the Bible that really encouraged me. And it is 1 John 2:14 or 2:15 to 2:17. And it says, do not love the world or the things in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the desires of the flesh and the desires of the eyes and pride of life, it is not from the Father, but is from the world. And the world is passing away along with its desires. But whoever does the will of God abides forever. So this just told me just to not love all the fleshly things and to strive for God's will. Amen.